Cause this is a Zen Dude show, and you know yo ho, coming on to blow. Psych, we ain't about that life, we about spreading positivity all over the night into the next morning. Can you figure out why the Zen Dude Nation is growing on the fly? Brandon, go ahead.
Yesterday I'm moving in the skies, and you will see me praying. I've been through the holy skies, praying for my family away over 1,000 miles, making music that can reach them.
Damn. I'm never gonna stop. What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to episode number 8 of Ask the Zen Dudes.
On today's episode, Dan's grandma is making us cookies.
I love my grandma. She makes the best cookies. Dude, what was the first thing I wanted to say on this? Oh, hope you guys like that intro music. It's from the official AK. He is a Zen Dude himself and has been following us for some time. And I thought we should put his intro music on the front of our bumper because the dude makes dope hip hop. So
he's a Zen dude. He makes dope music.
Check him out.
He needs to be in our intro.
Check him out. Makes sense. I just pasted his stuff right there. It's his YouTube channel.
In the description? It's his YouTube. You put it down there too?
I did.
Question one.
Link him up.
Link him up. Question number one.
Dude, we are not wasting any time, bro.
But a little bit of time.
Yeah, dude, you're right. We gotta waste a little bit of time, bro. How are you today? It's delightful. Steven asks, have you tried different strains of weed and found a nice mellow one that doesn't mess with your mellows? Have an awesome Sunday, dudes. Thanks, bro.
Yo, Steven, we're always trying to stay mellow. Mellow, mellow, like Carmelo. Anthony, know what I mean? Yo, we get real... Alright. So, Steven, dude, in Colombia, it's a little harder because people just sell organically. But if you live in a country, if you live in a state where it's legal, or a country where it's legal, you can find a nice sativa blend. And I would just like sample different ones and try to find maybe lower on the THC side is going to be helpful for you to be able to, like, you know, enjoy some marijuana, go jump some rope, get in the zone, move your body, you know, think about your life. Maybe do some introspection.
I think he's asking you specifically, though.
Oh, us personally.
Like you should give him your lowdown.
For me personally, I prefer sativa, and for here in Colombia, it's tough because we just get it from this guy who grows organic. But once we get back to the U.S., I'm definitely gonna find, like, you know, a low to mid THC sativa that's like chill, I can work with, but it's not gonna put me out.
And my answer is we've tried many different strains of weed to find the ones that work best with us. And that's why we talk about the education of people with marijuana, because not every strain is proper for some people. However, the right strain can have a huge benefit on your body and on your mind. So,
yeah,
I would just say for me, it's a hybrid indica sativa. Like when we were out in Hawaii, we got to try a bunch of like different like great types of weed. And the one I liked the most was a hybrid indica and sativa, because a solely sativa for me, I'm a very hyper person. I have a lot of hyperactivity built up inside of me. So an indica is actually kind of nice for me because it mellows me out, but I wouldn't do a whole indica because then I would get a little bit more lethargic and tired. So hybrid for me, I've found to be the best. Chris asks, when are you dudes coming to NYC for a ZDF boot camp retreat workout session? Your timing is on point, because I'm coming to New York in May, because I'm going to be going home. I'm from Pennsylvania, but I'm going to be taking the train up to New York and spending probably a week or two there. And the whole goal is actually to just put on a big meetup in the middle of either probably Manhattan, somewhere in Manhattan.
Well, Central Park action.
Central Park would be really good. Down by like the East Side River would also be kind of cool. But yeah, so there is going to be a meetup in New York. Comment below and let me know if you live in New York and if you want to do a Zen Dude meetup.
Holligible one time.
Yep. Mono asks, how to realistically keep going when you're going through a tough time in life to make sure that you don't lose motivation and focus? Go ahead, Brandon.
Man, Mono, you just got to figure out what your why is, man. You have to ask yourself, why do I want to go forward? Like, what is it? What is it that's motivating you? And try to always keep that in front of you and keep it as your focus. Because if you don't have a compelling why, like, I don't know, why would you do it? Like, I don't do a lot of things because my why isn't strong enough. And when for the things that my whys are strong enough, I commit to them, I work hard. So just connect whatever thing you want to do with your fitness to like whatever else you want to experience in life that like is your why.
Boom, great answer. The only thing I would add to that is when you're going through a... Dude, I would just put things into perspective and realize that most of the world is going through tough times that you will never, ever experience. So just reminding yourself to be present and just decide to be in a good mood. That's what I do a lot. Like, I just decide that, you know what? No matter what's going on in my life, I'm going to choose to be happy. Harry Roberts asks, tips on talking to the ladies.
Harry,
talk to the ladies.
You just do that. You do that.
You walk up to girls and say that to them.
Be yourself, Harry.
Yeah.
That's the best advice anyone could give you. Just be yourself. Because if you're trying to be someone else, and she's going to be attracted to someone else, when you go back to being the old version of you, she's going to be like, who's this dude? So be yourself.
Be yourself, Harry. I would say exactly what Brent said. You have to have self-confidence, man. You have to have self-confidence in who you are. And I guarantee you there's going to be a lot of girls out there who are like, I don't know what that Harry Roberts is.
Oh,
like,
Harry Roberts.
But I want that. I want you, Harry Roberts.
So I wonder what Harry Roberts' bed looks like. That's what they're thinking.
I wonder how
they're thinking, Harry.
Wonder how Harry Robert is.
Oh.
Like how hairy he is.
Yeah.
Francis asks, Dan, did you ever get those Jake Gyllenhaal single side swipe jumps? In all honesty, I have not yet, and I haven't been putting the time in to practice enough to get there, and that's shame on me, and I still need to do that. Thank you for holding me accountable. You the man, Francis. Nathan asks, do you think I'm the next Muhammad Ali, even though I can't stop losing my goddamn official fights?
Yo, Nathan, man. Dude, you're capable of whatever you decide you're capable of. So if you need better coaching, go find better coaching. If you need to put more time in and effort, put more time and effort in. If you need to improve your technique, then go do it. You will go as far as you decide you'll go, man. It's all between the ears. So what do you want, man? Do you want to be the next Muhammad Ali?
I want to leave you with this. Muhammad Ali would not ask other people if he thought that he was going to be great. Muhammad Ali believed he was going to be great. You have to believe in that same way. That
you got to believe!
That you're going to be great, dude. Colin asks, to achieve the macronutrient targets, I think I'm eating more than I did before. Is this simply eating more of the right sort of foods rather than less of the unhealthy stuff? P.S. When will we hear about the Costa Rica trip?
Colin, first of all, the Costa Rica trip is live, and we'll link it for you in the description again to sign up.
Mm-hmm.
As for the first part of your question, I guess the answer is no. We want you eating the right amount of calories and macronutrients, period. It doesn't matter what food they come from. Of course, we do want you to put effort into getting 70% of those from whole foods. But
whole foods just means real foods.
Real foods.
Like food not made by man. Meats, fruits, vegetables.
Exactly. So, yeah, man, it's not about like, okay, I can eat 1,000 calories of donuts and then I can eat 1,000 calorie broccoli. It's like, either way, you have to eat, 2,000 calories. You have to get 2,000 calories in. So if that's donuts and broccoli, cool, but don't just think about cutting out unhealthy food and not think about the total food consumption.
Totally. I totally agree. Val asks, there was something I wanted to ask about, but I just can't remember what it was. Oh, yes. Did she just have a conversation with herself? I love you, Val. Do HIIT workouts help with brain function?
I know exercise in general helps with brain function. So, yes, HIIT workouts work as well.
Yeah, and I don't know if there's some scientific study that says like you use more brain capacity when you're doing HIIT workouts. But personally, I do feel that I get more into a state of flow when I'm doing HIIT workouts, because when you're going as intense as possible, you have to be you're concentrating very hard on something, so it's easier to drop into a flow state.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Flow. Corey asks, heading to Ecuador in a week or so, bringing my rope. Good job. Tips on adjusting to the altitude. That's real. Land in Quito, there for a week. Then to Mindo, there for another week. Gonna do the thing daily. Corey, yes, Brandon, go.
Listen, you just need to go there and do what you can do, okay? So if usually back home you can do like 4 rounds and you go there and you can only do 3 rounds, that's cool. Just let it be. It's gonna be like that and you'll eventually adjust. So just be patient with yourself and do the thing.
Boom. Gershi asks, what kind of stretches do you do and how often do you do foam rolling? Side note, would love a stretching foam rolling video. Guess what, dude? That exists. Brandon, go ahead though.
I stretch like twice a week. Sunday is my big recovery day. Dan, you go.
For me, I stretch like stretch. I mean, I stretch a little bit before I dance, before I jump rope. I like, throw my hands down on my legs. But really what I do is I do a lot of foam rolling in my hips because they get super tight. And I also use a lacrosse ball to work out muscles around my back because that gets really tight as well. That I do every single day, and I would highly recommend that you guys do that. If you have any kind of muscular pain, get a foam roller and a lacrosse ball. And the easiest way to describe what you do is you just lay on where the pain is and you press the pain out. Like literally where it hurts the most, just lay on that. And the pain will actually dissipate. It's kind of a crazy thing. Hmm. And you'll feel much better afterward.
Rub it out.
Rub it out. And check out our How to Prevent Injury video. That will tell you
everything. That stretches as well.
Yeah,
the jump
stretches. Yeah. Lilla! Hey, Lilla.
Lilla the killer.
Lilla the killer. If you could live in a book, TV show, or movie, what would it be?
I think Inception would be an interesting movie to be in and just go play around, because I think consciousness is a really, it's just a huge trip for me. And so to be able to play with consciousness that way and create your own reality around you, I think I might want to be in that movie. I don't know.
Yeah, it's a good answer. That's, Inception's a really good answer. I think when I first read this question, I kind of think that I'll be honest with you, I kind of think that this already is a movie. And like, I mean this. I try and live my life in a way that it could be a movie. Like, that's my biggest goal, because that for me is what creates the most amount of fulfillment and happiness. So I think like what I'm currently, like my current life, I'm like, yeah, I just want to keep making this more like a movie. But if I had to pick an already existing movie, man, I'm just going to go top of my head. Top of my head, probably the Avengers, because, you know, I'd like to be Iron Man. I'd like to be Iron Man and just kind of have a whole skyscraper in New York City and be that intelligent. So that's what I would say. I would want to be Tony. Anathan asks, how do you cope after an 11-day binge session? Chill.
Take a deep breath.
Don't make it a 12.
Don't make it a 12. No, take a deep breath. And just figure out what your calorie and macronutrient budget is for that day.
Link below. The link for our macronutrient calculator is right down below.
Get those numbers and then plug in what you're eating that day into MyFitnessPal and just hit those numbers. That's it. Don't overcomplicate it. Hit those numbers and just start stacking one day on top of the next. Really just apply yourself to those tactics and you're going to break out of it. You're going to break out of it. You're going to break out of it. You're going to make it. You're
going to do it. Yeah, the biggest thing you need to do is just like not worry that you had an 11-day binge session.
Who cares?
Just stop right now. I hate when people hit us back and they're like, oh, but like everything's going bad, so I have to keep doing this for like, no, dude, just stop right now.
Stop it.
Don't make a 12-day binge session. We believe in you. Come on. Corey, do you play video games?
Currently, I do not play video games, but I played a lot of Madden back in the day. I was a big football video game guy. I was never much of a shooter game.
I was a shooter.
That's me.
Dude, I was one of those messed up kids who played Grand Theft Auto just to kill people.
Oh, yeah, well,
I would run by that. Oh, you did that too?
I did that.
I don't feel as crazy.
I feel like every teenage kid just spent hours binging on just killing people randomly, getting stars on Grand Theft Auto.
It was so fun.
It was.
Yeah. But it didn't make me violent. I kind of don't like when people are like, yeah, like dude played that video game, so he turned violent. It's like, nah, dude, I played some pretty violent games as a kid.
Like football, that's a violent game.
Well, like, I played all fighter games. I don't play video games now, but I played all fighter games growing up. I used to play a lot of Sega, so like Sonic, Streets of Rage. Yo, do you remember Streets of Rage?
It's beyond my time. Before my time.
Brada Ben, do these questions ever get answered? It's funny you ask that question, because I feel like this is the answer. Go.
We answered it last week. We answered your question. Watch the last video.
Just watch these videos. Totally cool that you didn't know, but this is where the questions get answered, Brada Ben. Kathy asks, when did you both start jumping rope, and how much time did you put into it daily? What jumps cause you the most problem? That's a great question.
Kathy, I started jumping rope really about 2 years ago, I'd say. A little more than 2 years, more or less. And then once I started, I jump rope in the beginning like 3 to 5 times a week. And now I jump rope almost every day, if not every day, 6 days a week. And the trick I had the most trouble with was crisscross. It took me a while to get the crisscross done.
Crisscross like a boss. That's a tough one, man. I started jumping rope probably 4 to 5 years ago. and how much time did I put into it daily? I mean, when I started every day, like every day for 30 to 40 minutes, the tricks that gave me the most trouble, probably crisscross, definitely crisscross, and consecutive double unders. Like that was just really hard for me to get down, like where I was doing a lot of them at once. So,
yeah.
Barry, what's going on, my friend? Dude, Barry actually is from a town near my hometown, and we went to the same college.
No way. Was he a homie from college?
No, dude, he would have totally been a homie had I known him, but I think we ran in like
different circles,
but like kind of we know some of the same people.
Yeah.
Anyway, Barry, we appreciate your support, brother. What has been the hardest part of being an entrepreneur? Dude, that's a great question.
The hardest part of being an entrepreneur is just having faith that something that's not here in the physical reality right now will be there in the future. You just have to assume that like you're gonna make something that's never existed before. And it's just that faith, because it's so easy to be like, the fear is taking me over, and like, is this really possible for my life? But if you have faith and you hold on to that, I think that's what sees you through. So,
dude,
it's always a mental game.
Dude, your answer is literally my answer. The hardest part is not the actual like making something or whatever. It's the mindset. Like, dude, you have to, as an entrepreneur, like you have to totally decide to take on this mindset that you are going to be successful, and there's no plan B. Like you're going full into this.
Burn the ships.
You either are gonna die, or this is gonna become successful, or you're gonna die doing it. And like, I know that sounds a little bit harsh, man, but I really think enough people don't focus on that. They focus on the strategy and tactic side. If you decide you wanna be an entrepreneur, I think you just have to.
You just go.
Completely change your mindset to think, I'm going to be successful. It might not be this business that I'm starting right now, but like in my lifetime, I'm going to be successful. And like nail that, tattoo that on your brain, and tell yourself that every single day a million times. Jamie asks, what are the Zen Dude's thoughts on a ketogenic diet?
Ah, the old ketogenic diet, bro. Jamie, my dude, I know, I'm assuming since you have an Amazon business that you're in the circle of listening to Tim Ferriss and like a lot of other productivity entrepreneur podcasts or health podcasts that talk about the ketogenic diet. At the end of the day, for us, like it definitely can work and give you a given result, but we just don't like dieting. We just want to be able to eat the foods that we want. And we've seen that through the way we eat, by counting calories and macronutrients and trying to eat a lot of real whole foods, that's very possible. So for us, it's like, there's too much pain involved with dieting to actually want to do it. And so that's why we don't do it and we don't recommend it.
Yeah, also I think like just the simple, what a diet implies that you're cutting things out. And I think cutting anything out of your, like saying I can't eat sugar anymore forever because I'm on this kind of diet, or I can't have carbs because I'm on this kind of diet, is not the right way to approach it. And like a diet, like dieting is the problem in general. You should be able to eat every type of food that's out there, just in the right amounts, and be able to control your temptation around it, rather than saying I can no longer live my life eating this food. Gabriel asks, dude, Malachi, you ready? Any specific suggestions for teens doing ZDF workouts?
Man, my biggest suggestion is just have fun with it. Like there shouldn't be any really intense pressure about a certain result. Like when you're a teenager, just have fun, learn to jump rope, and don't stress yourself out about like having to do it every single day. Make it fun, my dude.
Dylan asks, hey dudes, once again, you guys are the shit. Yo, that's funny, thanks, Dylan, because I think you the shit.
Shoo.
My question is, have you ever done a Spartan race, warrior dash, or any insane obstacle race? I'm itching to do one because of the degree of difficulty that comes with it. I want to reach the level of ninja you two are at.
Go Dylan, ahead. I've never done one, but I highly recommend that you do it if you want to do it, because I think things like that help you achieve a new mental level, because you've never done something like that. If you do it, you're going to prove yourself something. At the same time, make sure it's something that you want to do, that you think is like least decently fun. Otherwise, push yourself in another direction that is equally challenging but more fun.
Totally agree with Brandon. I was signed up for a Tough Mudder race when I lived in Washington, D.C., but I stopped seeing the girl that I was dating, who we were going to go on that together.
Tough Mudder race date.
Tough Mudder, yeah. Tough Mudder race.
Sure.
Those girls in DC, you know, they like to stay active. Lewis asks, hey Zen dudes. Hey Luis. I have a question. On rest days, parentheses, once a week, should I keep the same macros, specifically carbs for muscle repairing, or would it turn into fat? Greetings from Mexico City, dude.
What up, Mexico City?
Wow, we really want to come to Mexico
City. Really want to go to Mexico City.
Like soon.
Maybe that should be what we do in July.
Ooh, shit. Before.
That'd be crazy.
That'd be crazy.
All right, my dude, let me answer your question. When you get your calorie and macronutrient numbers from our calculator, it asks you how many times you exercise a week and just factors that into the numbers that it gives you. So if it says you're working out 3 to 4 times a week and you get your numbers based upon that, then it knows that you're gonna eat those calories and macronutrients each day. So don't think about eating like calorie and macronutrient workout days versus non-workout days. People do that who are really into like bodybuilding and like and just want to dial in every little body fat percentage, but you honestly don't need to do that. Just listen to the numbers every day the calculator gives you.
Dude, just focus more on being super intense during your workouts. That's also a big one too. Mm. So the food should come easier and easier as you go about it. Keep the same macros, keep it simple like Brandon talked about, and just do the thing.
Do it then.
Lakshaya asks, how do you make the coffee drink which you guys drink early morning every day? Nice, what's our coffee drink in the morning?
We go to, oh, well, two things. I don't know what you're talking about. Oh, the coffee drink. We go to cafes. We live in Colombia, so the Americanos here are the best I've ever tasted anywhere in my life. So
have you ever had Colombian cafe cases?
So, man, we just get people to make us Americanos here.
Yep. but I get Poco Leche Fria, which is a little bit of cold milk.
Mm.
Because my stomach doesn't do well totally fasted with coffee. I need some fat in there, so I put milk. So you can do that as long as you keep it under 50 calories. Remember that. Ooh, also, side note, I've been recently getting cappuccinos in the morning, which totally will break your fast, technically, because it's like, it's a lot of milk.
Uh-huh.
But I don't mind that. And I still think I'm getting some of the benefits from delaying that eating window, even if I'm slightly breaking my fast. Does that make sense?
Yeah, absolutely.
Because you're still only like, you're very low calorie still for a large portion.
Maybe you're at 120 calories.
Yeah. So I'm playing with that and I'm doing it because it does make my stomach feel better when I have 0 calories and try to drink coffee. My stomach's like, damn, yo, now I'm going to have diarrhea. Vince asks, Zandu Brades! What's up, man? I've been listening to your podcast and it's pretty satisfying to let you let out all the things you want to say. My question is, what happened to the Zen Dude TV YouTube channel?
Great question, bro. Great question. Zen Dude TV YouTube channel is a project that we have. We want to create like investigative shows and just really dive into topics we think are interesting. It's just kind of on the back burner right now because we're just so...
Just jumping rope.
We're really busy jumping rope.
Jumping rope. But Zen Dude TV will be a thing because Brandon and I, just to let you guys know who don't, we just want to have a TV show and like a production company and just make really dope content all the time in really cool places. So that's like our future, like down the road a little bit, channel.
Straight up.
Kaola! I hope I'm saying your name right. Kaola.
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 Can
intermittent fasting cause an eating disorder? Brandon, go.
I think if you already have an eating disorder, I wouldn't do intermittent fasting just because it is kind of like an extreme thing where you're getting in this kind of rigid system around eating, fasting for 16 hours and eating for 8 hours, or if you're a woman, you know, fasting for 12 hours, eating for 12 hours. So I would just focus more on eating whole foods, moving your body, and if you have issues with eating disorders in the past, then work your way into being more conscious about calories and macronutrients, and don't put too much pressure on the process.
Yes, intermittent fasting, if you let it, could cause an eating disorder, and that's what a lot of people need to be careful of, because guys, we do not promote intermittent fasting so that you just stop eating your food, and that's what can happen. Mm-hmm. I have seen people say, well, Dan, I'm losing a bunch of weight, I'm intermittent fasting, and I'm like, bro, you're eating 1,200 calories a day, you need to be eating 2,000. So be careful of that, because I have seen that happen with some people. However, having said that, intermittent fasting is not the cause of the eating disorder, mm-hmm. it's the person who's doing it. So at the end of the day, just make sure to hit your calories and macros. If you decide to condense that eating window in which you're hitting those calories and macros, that's fine. But you're in control here. Amar asks, what do I do if I can't move on to do another round in the workout? Do I take longer rests or should I stop?
Ah, Amar, if you got the time, man, give yourself maybe a 2-minute rest instead of a 1-minute rest, and then throw some more rounds on there, bro.
Totally agree, dude.
Michael asks, have you been on fitness magazines?
No.
Yeah, I have. I was on Playgirls fitness magazine.
Ah.
Yeah, I was on Playgirls
pornography magazine.
It's not porn, it's fitness. Sex is fitness. You know that. You know that. I know that.
We'd like to shout out our sponsors today, Athletic Greens and Crossrope. Athletic Greens is a company that makes the protein that we take, which is grass-fed, non-antibiotic, non-sh-tives. So that's why we take it.
But Pro Gains.
Pro Gains, homie. It's linked in the description below. Athletic Greens is our supplement that we take sometimes. Not take sometimes, we take every day to help us get our greens in, because it's the equivalent to, I believe, 13 servings of fruits and vegetables, something like that. That doesn't mean, something like that.
It's a lot of vegetables.
So it doesn't mean you should just take that and not eat vegetables at all, but when you can't get your vegetables in, it's a good supplement. And when you can, that's just extra micros for you, homie.
And the other sponsor that we want to shout out, listen, ladies and gentlemen, it's the best rope company on the market. It's Cross Rope, okay?
Yo. Sitting here in Medellin. No, I don't wear jeans, I wear sweats, because all I do is jump to the rope to hip hop. Hip, hip, hop, the fun don't stop. When I listen to my hip hop and I jump rope, you know I'm about to go and elope with my rope and my hip hop. Getting down like K-Dot. Yeah, Kendrick just dropped a new song. I heard he was calling some dudes out, saying mean things. I'm not about that life. No thanks. Hey, I just want to be a nice guy.
Yo, then I stepped in. I took it for the win, mother. Did I sin? Yes, motherfucker, cause this is a Zen Dude show. And you know, yo ho, coming on to blow. Psych, we ain't about that life. We out spreading positivity all over the night into the next morning. Can you figure out why? The Zen Dude Nation is growing on the fly.